Well, first of all, I want to just happy for our team. You know, just really excited about them. You know, we started off a little slow there, but I thought we bounced back and, you know, played well once we had a slow start. But, you know, pleased with the way we finished. Like I said, I thought offensively we came back after that slow start and did some good things. I thought Coach Jasper and the offensive staff did some good things. You know, Keenan and, you know, got us in the right play. They're trying to move around a little bit, and he did a good job of just being patient, finding what they're doing and getting some good plays. It's just, I was pleased with the patience of our and the experience of our offensive guys. I had no idea what to expect defensively. I tell you what, really, really happy. Really happy the way we played. I thought, you know, Coach Pearson, under the circumstances that he got put in as a coordinator, I mean, who changes coordinators during camp? And I thought he and our defensive staff came up with a great game plan. Thought our kids executed well. You know, this was a great game for us because we were able to play pretty much, we got to play a lot of guys, you know, to try to get some experience, you know, while maintaining that we got a long season, just being smart with our starters. And so it couldn't have turned out better for us, you know, where we played well in all phases and allowed our young guys to get some reps and, you know, fortunately came out healthy in this game.
Questions?
Ken, it felt like Colgate was doing everything they could to take Keenan away, and you were able to lean on the B-backs. Just your thoughts on how they performed.
Well, that's, you know, we pretty much know that people are going to try to take away 19, and our thoughts is we got three fullbacks that are 345 and above, and if that's going to be your plan, you know, we'll live with it. You know what I mean? And so I think that's only going to continue to help Keenan and our whole offense because you can't just key on Keenan. You know, we're going to try to hit you in the middle with stuff, keep people honest. And we like our A-backs that we have to pitch the ball to on the perimeter. And we saw when we were able to get the ball to Jameer, another guy. I mean, we got a guy that is a pretty explosive guy on the edge, too. So I think I was happy, like I said, just I thought what happened offensively, you know, we took what they gave us. And that's who we are. I mean, that's who we are as an offense. We come out. We weren't really sure how they were going to line up. We prepared for a few things. And then as soon as we saw how they're lining up, you know, they pretty much lined up how Rutgers lined up, and then we just adjusted from there.
When Chris had that first series where he fumbled and he had a holding penalty, did you want to go back to him right away to kind of get him started?
Yeah. I mean, you can see, I mean, what did he have, Scott?
I think it was like 126.
I mean, that's, you know, I mean, what he did was not a surprise. You know what I mean? He's probably one of the fastest guys on our team, you know, and one of the strongest guys on our team. And so he just had to settle down. And really, him and Keenan never got hit for 8 months. You know, we had a bubble wrap around those two guys. You know, it was like construction on the freeway where they have all those things. But you better stay out of that zone or you're going to get a fine. And anybody comes close to Keenan, anybody gets close to Swain, they knew they were going to be running. And so that was really the first time those guys got hit since San Diego State.
Ken, you said, you know, that people are going to do this, try to take Keenan away. One, you had to be really happy that Keenan, I think, had like 110 yards offense, and yet you won going away. And two, do you think after this game, maybe people maybe rethink that idea when Swain and the other fullbacks played so well?
We're an option team, and football's not really complicated. If they're over there, go over there. If they're over there, go over there. You know, we try to make this like it's some complicated thing. I mean, like that keyboard, I have no idea what those buttons mean, but, you know, it's just football. You know what I mean? There's 11 guys on the field, and go where there's less people. And that's really, it's a physical game. It's a fight. And you just got to keep it that way. And fortunately, we got a smart quarterback. And there's nothing people can do that he hasn't seen. So if they do things, he just gets us in the right play.
You talked about the defense. Defensively, it looked like they really stood their ground on a lot of the short situations, 4th-and-1, 3rd-and-1. You had to be pretty pleased with Bernard and how they came up in those situations particularly.
We played exactly, you know, how I was hoping we'd play defensively. Stout against the run, didn't give up, you know, that big pass play at the end. You know, Sean Williams is in great position. The kid made a great play. You got to tip your hat off to him. I think people thought when we said we're going to blitz, you know, I mean, that we were going to, you know, blitz 11 guys and, you know, be crazy. I mean, I've been here long enough to recognize who we are. But we had to pressure him. And I thought our pressure was just enough to keep them off balance. We were stout in the run game. Our eyes are perfect in the secondary. Just really happy the way we played defensively.
Coach, how much of a charge do you get out of opening the season at home and that atmosphere and all?
I tell you, you know, Mr. Gladchuk's done a phenomenal job on our stadium. You know what I mean? I don't know if any of you guys have been up to the Ackerson Towers. I mean, this is beautiful right here. I mean, he's done a great job with this stadium. Our stadium, we've been to a lot of venues because we're independent. Our stadium may not be as big as other people, but our stadium and this environment is as good as anywhere in the country. So it's a huge home field advantage for us when we come home to have the brigade here, have kids sliding down the hill, you know, there. I mean, that's great for our players. And so it's definitely a great advantage for us to play at home.
Kenny, going back to the fullbacks a little bit, obviously we know what Chris can do. He's proven that. But Quentin and Sean White came on and both scored touchdowns, had some nice runs. On the Sean White's touchdown, he ran over two guys. I mean, literally ran over. Do you think that those guys coming in fresh with their size can be really wear teams down?
We knew this was coming. You know, I mean, we've been talking about this in offseason, that we knew we had three guys inside that are as big as we've ever had and are as fast as we've ever had, and they're smart football players. And so, you know, we know that we got one of the best quarterbacks in the country, and people got a big target on him. All eyes are on him. So our thought process in the offseason, we got to do some things that where they don't have 11 guys trying to kill Keenan, you know, and try to soften people up. But those younger guys, Wags, I mean, we know they can play. We've seen enough of them in practice, in other situations, that what they did wasn't a surprise. I mean, they've been doing it all camp and all offseason.
Brendan did not start today. I think a disciplinary situation. I think he's suspended for the first half. Can you just, is that a violation of team rules, academy rules, or?
Yeah, I'll just keep that in-house. You know what I mean? He's a good kid. My deal is, you know what I mean, we all make decisions we regret. He served his punishment, and we've moved on. You know what I mean? I'm not going to continue to dwell on it. Just we're all human, and we do things we wish we wouldn't have done. But he served his penalty, which is a huge penalty. I mean, we only got, well, hopefully we play more than 12 games, but you only have 12 opportunities, so to miss a half. And if people knew why I fined or suspended him, I guarantee you there's not any other coach in the country that would have suspended him for a half for what we did. But we got different standards here, and it is what it is. And, you know, I don't make any complaints about it or don't try to make any excuses. We're the Naval Academy, and we were held to a different standard.
And what happened with Meyer Kroll in the first half? It looked like things got real heated, and you sent him off the field, and he did not return to the game.
Like I said, that's in-house stuff. You know, I mean, Meyer's, you know, one of our best players. He's a good kid, good person. He's emotional. I'm emotional. You know what I mean? He's a good kid. We'll just leave it at that.
Again, with regard to the punters, you gave both guys chances to kick. Is there any? Did you learn anything from either one? Any separation from either of those guys?
No, they punted like how they've been punting during practice. I mean, they're both very good. You know what I mean? They did a good job. That's going to be a tough battle. And, you know, we punted them both, and they both did a good job. And, you know, Alex obviously had a huge punt. But when Gavin got in there, he had a nice punt, too.
To get Nick out there for that kick, just get him some work? Or?
Keenan, back in media day, you were talking about, you know, this team can't just be about me. Obviously today, you probably had the lowest numbers you had in a while in terms of total offense, and you guys went going away. How good did you feel seeing what the game unfold the way it did?
It's huge. You know, you got your coach talking about our B-backs. I mean, we got to get those guys going. And you got Quentin and Chris and then Sean White, too. I mean, you got three guys, 250-plus. They can run, you know, they can move like an A-back. So get them the ball, you know, let them make hay, you know. So I knew what the game plan was going to be coming in. And, you know, you just take what the defense gives you. They give us the dive, you give a hand the ball off. They maybe pitch it, I pitch it. So, I mean, I don't really get too caught up in numbers and all that stuff because at the end of the day, you know, it's all about just execution. And if execution means those guys rush for 300 yards combined and I got 2 yards, then so be it. And that's how I approach the game.
Early on, was it frustrating at all when there were so many guys hitting you, smacking you, and you weren't really, you had no room to run?
No, I mean, it's part of the game. I mean, I expect to get banged up a little bit. They're going to hit me. It's option offense. That's what they have to do. So, I mean, it wasn't anything I didn't expect, and, you know, I wouldn't say I was frustrated.
Chris, you had a career high of rushing 126 yards, but what were you thinking after that first series? You had a holding penalty, thrown for a five-yard loss and a fumble. How do you, did you just think, oh, my God, I got to bounce back from this?
Yeah, I was really nervous at first, and I really just calmed down. I was talking to Keenan and Coach, and they just calmed me down. And after that, I just got better and better. That's really about it.
Yeah, Chris, just your thoughts on how the other B-backs were able to kind of come in after you and kind of keep the team going in the second half.
Oh, yeah, I knew it was going to happen. We all practice hard. We all expect to play well when we go out there. And nothing was a surprise. I knew they both would do their job and execute.
Quinn, can you talk a little bit about the home atmosphere? This is probably the first time a lot of you guys played the opener at home.
The home atmosphere is great. Being a guy from Maryland, had my family out there. It was just great to play in front of them again. But I love our fans. The brigade was out there supporting us. A lot of good support at home games.
Hey, Keenan, you guys put up a nice number offensively as far as yards and points, but I'm guessing that you probably saw some things that can be corrected. You think there's some things that can be cleaned up?
Absolutely. We can't play like we played today and expect to be successful in 2 weeks. So, we got a week off, and that's going to be an opportunity for us to get after it, get on the grind, and correct those mistakes. Obviously, there's a lot of things that, we'll probably see when we watch the tape that we don't obviously know right now, that we couldn't point out right now. But the goal is just to get better. I mean, it's a one-game season for us each week, so we got 2 weeks for our next season finale, in my opinion. So we're going to approach it that way. We're going to get better, and we're going to work to move forward.
Chris, what was your take on the offensive line's play today?
Oh, I thought they did real well. They made open holes along with the A-backs. They all blocked and the receivers. There's still a lot of yards I left out there, but I'll get that corrected in the film room practice next week. And hopefully in 2 weeks, I'll be ready for ECU.
The defensive guys.
Hey, Bernie, a coach talked about being really happy with the way the defense played, given that Coach Person had taken over as a coordinator and in camp. Just your thoughts on how you guys kind of acquitted yourself in the opening game.
Yeah, I mean, Coach Pearson did a great job getting us ready over those 3 weeks, he put in charge and, he kind of put his wrinkle on things and, coached us up and we took it around with it. And I think it showed today, what we were trying to do for the majority of the game. We did a good job shutting down the run with them. Colgate ran the ball well last year and that's probably going to be their identity. So I think, especially the front seven guys, we can take that as a positive note. And, I think just overall defense played well and gave our offense a chance to put points up and give ourselves a chance to win.
Will, when you start off that first defensive series in a bad position, you only hold them to three, just did that kind of jumpstart, kind of how the defense was going to play the rest of the day?
It did. Those 3 points did get to me, and that's what I let drive me for the rest of the game, yeah.
Kevin, you weren't even listed on the two deep coming into this game. You ended up playing considerable amount, I guess, at Raider. Were you playing Raider?
Yes, sir.
We'll just kind of tell you your thoughts of, getting in there and you get a fumble recovery, you get a forced fumble. It must have been quite a day for you.
Well, the biggest thing our coaches tell us is that, if you're going to travel to the game, then you're going to play and that you need to be ready. And, I was as ready as any other guy. And I was, I knew exactly what was going to happen, what plays they was going to run, so I just kept playing it in my head, and, I just, when it happened, and I just reacted to it.
When's the last time you scored a touchdown?
Never. I've never scored before.
Well, you guys looked like you played especially well in those third and one, fourth and one short situations. The game was already one-sided, and you guys are still rising up on defense. You're not even thinking about the score. It's just like we're stopping them here and getting the ball, funds the ball back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that definitely. Whenever I'm out there, I don't really ever try to think about what down it is or whatever. Because I mean, sometimes a little bit, I guess, on third down or whatever. But we knew they were going to run the ball a lot, and we knew we had to lock it down in the inside. So that definitely drove us.
For either you or Bernie, could your last home opener have been any better than this one?
I think it was a little hot, but maybe toned it down 10 degrees. But no, I mean, Brigade was rocking. It was a great turnout. You know, and just getting any type of win is always good to start the season off. So, you know, we're just going to take the positives, fix the negatives, and get running from there.